The little village of Talysh is now a trophy for Azerbaijan's army. Until yesterday, it was a home of ethnic Armenians in Nagorno-Karabakh, near the front lines of what's become a full-blown war. Militarily, Azerbaijan appears to have the upper hand, firing repeatedly at what it claimed were military targets in the disputed territory's capital of Stepanakert. But Armenia says only civilians were hit, and it struck back at Azerbaijan cities, some 60 kilometers from the front lines. In Moscow, we spoke to prominent Azerbaijani community leader Shamil Tagiev. I'd like to convince my Canadian friends that Azerbaijan is not the aggressor, but the victim, he said, because for more than 30 years, the land of Azerbaijan has been recognized by all international organizations that it is occupied.
While Azerbaijan has spent years bolstering its military and waiting for the right moment to strike, it's Turkey that's tipped the balance by providing key military and political support.
Armenia claims videos such as this show Turkey bringing in militants from Syria to fight against them.
What we're witnessing right now is an existential moment.
Renowned filmmaker and Armenian-Canadian Atom Egoyan has written to the Prime Minister saying he and other prominent Canadians fear genocide and ethnic cleansing if Azerbaijan prevails. They want Ottawa to push Turkey to get out of the conflict.
There's been a huge toll already in civilian deaths and injuries. Canada has to react to that and say that this is not acceptable from a NATO ally.
Today, Ottawa responded in part by suspending permits for military exports to Turkey that could include Canadian-made targeting sensors for Turkish drones until it's clear how they're being used. Chris Brown, CBC News, Moscow.